We continue now at the top of Daf Ayin Amud Beis and Maseches Pesachim. This is Pesachim Daf 70b. The Gemara now is suggesting again that the Mishnah, when it says that if you find this kofetz, if you find this cleaver on the 14th, you have to assume that it's tamei, is because again there's no bones to be broken. Even though technically, if you have a chagiga, you really could break the bones. It could be this Mishnah follows the Rabbanan. Still, in this particular case in the Mishnah, there was no carbon chagiga. Why? B'meruba, because there was a lot. Meaning there was a lot of meat for each person. When you have a situation of a lot of meat for each person, then you don't have to bring a carbon chagiga. Rashi says b'meruba b'chabura muetis, meaning you have a small group. Sha'pesach meruba lahen, so they have a lot of carbon pesach for each of them. Below yaviu chagiga. So again, the Mishnah is assuming there's no carbon chagiga, similar to the answer the Gemara gave on the previous Amud, that it's talking about on Shabbos when there's no carbon chagiga, but the Gemara rejected that answer. So here also, there's a lot of meat, and therefore there's no carbon chagiga. That's why you have to assume the kofetz it's tameh, because there was nothing to purify it for if there was no carbon chagiga to break the bones. But the Gemara says still, minna yadi, how would anybody know? Meaning, how would the owner have known that there would be a lot of meat? There are always people that are constantly joining the chabura, Rashi says, and the group of people gets more and more. So you're not going to know. You're not going to realize that that's going to be the situation. Rashi says, "Mino yodi abaylim b'shlosha asr shetei chaburas umuetis." How would the owners know on the 13th already that they're going to have a small group in comparison with the amount of meat? They're going to have a lot of meat. There's no chagiga. Maybe they're not going to realize. They think they might have a carbon chagiga. So that can't be a good answer for the end of the Mishnah. So instead, the Gemara says, "V'elo sheba betumah." Okay, so the case is over here. You brought the Karban Pesach bitumah. The majority of the tzibra was tameh. And again, we said if the majority of the tzibra is tameh, you don't bring the chagiga. So again, there's no chagiga, so there's nothing to use this kofetz for, so you have to assume it's tameh. But the Gemara says still, sof, mino yadi. Still, how do they really know that it's going to be bitumah? Rashi says, mino yadi habaylim b'shlosha asr kishematvilin sakineyem shihu rov tzibur tzimeyin. How would the owners know already on the 13th when they're starting to immerse and purify things, how would they know that most of the tzibur is going to be tameh? So the Gemara says, no, everybody knows the mis nasi, because the nasi is the one who died, the leader of the people, and it's a mitzvah for all of Klal Yisrael to be part of the funeral, so everyone knows that it's the most of the tzibur, the majority of the tzibur, if not all of the tzibur, is going to be tameh, so people were aware. But the Gemara still is not satisfied. The mis nasi emas, when exactly did the nasi die? Ilema de mis b'shlosha asr. Now, if the nasi died on the 13th, so sakin lamali demitvali, there's no reason to purify the knife because you don't even have to bring it betara anymore. Now everyone's going to be bringing betuma. V'yela de mis b'arba asr. So then you're going to say, no, he died on the 14th. So ma'ishna sakin de matvil. So what's the difference by the knife where the person, you assume the person already did the immersion? U'ma'ishna kofetz de lo matvila. What's the difference by the kofetz which he didn't? He's not going to know the future. He's not going to be aware of what's going on. So at the point, if he dies on the 14th, on the 13th, when everyone is immersing everything, they don't realize. And so again, the kofetz should be considered to be pure. So the Gemara says, lo tzricha, no, the case is needed as follows. The nasi goses, the nasi is a goses, meaning he's on his deathbed. People know that he's going to die very soon. So b'shlosh asr, and that's already on the 13th that he's a goses. So sakin d'chad sveika, so when it comes to the knife, there's only one doubt involved. So matvil lo, he's going to be matvil, meaning when it comes to the knife, we're not sure whether you're going to be bringing the Karban Pesach betumah or betara. We don't know when this nasi is going to die. So you're going to immerse it just in case you have to bring it betara. But kofetz to trei sveiki. Kofetz involves already two sveikas, lo matvila. That you're not going to assume it was already immersed the day before. And Rashi explains, sakin dechad sveika, there's only one doubt by a knife. Hudik alamemar, shema yamus hanasi. The suffix is maybe the nasi will die. V'yasu Pesach betumah, maybe we'll bring Karban Pesach betumah. So mishum hach sveika, just because this doubt that you might be able to bring betumah, lo imna milatvula viatvula dechay shema lo yamos viasa pesach betar. We can assume the owner immersed it. He's not going to refrain from immersing it just because of this possibility, and therefore you can assume it's tar. Aval kofetz de trei sveiki, but when it comes to the cleaver, there's already two doubts. Islay misalki le mitoras tvila. Then already he's not going to. We're going to assume he doesn't immerse it. What are the two sveikas? Shema yamos velo yaviu chagigas lo biarbas or velo bechamisha. So number one, he might die, and then there's not even going to be a carbon chagiga because you don't bring the carbon chagiga betuma. Or afilo lo yamos, and even if he doesn't die, shema ani lo itzdarich lechagigas arbaser. Maybe I won't need to bring a chagiga. Shetei chaburasi muetes viavu pesach b'meruba, because maybe there'll be a lot of meat. As we said, if there's a lot of meat in the carbon pesach, it's a small group. You don't bring it. Vimishum chagigas chag chamisha. So now, if you're going to say, what about the chagiga of the 15th? Adayin yeshos latvila biyadalid. I can immerse it on the 14th if I need to. Hilchach loetvul amar b'shlosh aser. So for that, you don't assume that the owner already immersed it. And the Gemara continues. Tanya, we learned in a Braisa, Yehuda ben Dorsai Pirushu, he separated from everybody else because he held the Chagiga of the 14th did in fact even need to be brought on Shabbos. So Pirushu v'Dorsai beno, him and Dorsai, his son, they separated. V'holach v'yashav lo bedarm, they went and they settled in the south. Amar, he said to himself as follows, if Eliyahu Navi should come and tell Klal Yisrael, why didn't you bring the carbon chagiga of the 14th on Shabbos? What are they going to tell him? They're making a mistake. I'm shocked by the two gedolei hador, Shmaya ve'Avtalion, which are Shmaya and Avtalion, shein chachamim gedolim, they're great chachamim, v'darshinan gedolim, they say great drushes, v'lo amru lehen liYisrael chagiga doches haShabbos, yet they haven't told Klal Yisrael that the carbon chagiga is doches haShabbos. So therefore they decided, we're going to stay very far away. If we're very far away, we're putter anyway from the carbon chagiga, that's how we're going to avoid having a chiyuv. And the Gemara continues, Amar Rav says, my time would have Ben Dorsai. What is the reason of Ben Dorsai? Where does he get this idea that the Karban Chagig of the 14th can be Docha Shabbos? Tichsiv, because the Pasuk says, Vizavachto Pesach LaHashem Elokecha Tzon Uvakar. It says you're going to bring the Karban Pesach, Tzon and Bakar. What does it mean, Bakar? V'aloin Pesach Elamin Akvasum Aminoizim. Isn't it true that the Karban Pesach only comes from sheep and goats? This is the same Jerusha that Rashi quoted in the previous Amud. The same Pasuk that Rashi quoted. So what does it mean, Elatzon Zepesach? Rather, the word Tzon is a reference to Karban Pesach, and Bakar Zuchagiga, and Bakar. Bakar is a reference to Karban Chagiga of Yom Rachmana Vizavachta Pesach. And the Pasuk says Vizavachta Pesach. And the idea is that the Karban Chagiga is just like the Karban Pesach. Just like the Karban Pesach is Docha Shabbos, so too the Karban Chagiga of Yudalit should be Docha Shabbos. So Amar Ravashi says, V'anon taima deprushim neko v'nifrish. Do we have to explain the reasoning of people who separated from everyone else? We don't need to explain the Pasuk this way. Elakra l'chid Rav Nachman hudasa. Rather, the Pasuk comes for the drush of Rav Nachman. The Amar Rav Nachman, Amar Rava bar Avua, because Rav Nachman said, in the name of Rava bar Avua, Minayin lemosar ha-pesach shekarev shlomim. How do you know that if you have extra carbon pesachs, you can bring them instead as a carbon shlomim? Shenemar, like the Pasuk says, v'zavachto pesach la-Hashem elokecha tzon uvakar, same Pasuk. It says you're going to bring the carbon pesach, tzon and bakar. V'chi pesach min ha-bakar ba, does pesach come? Does the carbon pesach come from bakar? V'aloin pesach ba ela min ha-kvasim, min ha-izim. Isn't it true that the carbon pesach only comes from sheep and goats? Elemosar ha-pesach yehe ledover ha-ba min ha-tzon min ha-bakar. What it means is, if you have extra animals that you had originally designated as Karban Pesach, you can bring them as Shlomim, meaning something which is brought from Tzon and Bakar. And the Gemara says, V'Rabbanan, my time a lo dochi Shabbos. But in any case, according to the Rabbanan, why isn't the Karban Chagiga of Yodala docha Shabbos? Havadai Karban Sibur, who certainly it's a Karban Sibur, in general you have a Karban Sibur, is docha Shabbos. Amar Rabbi Law, Mishum Rabbi Yehuda ben Safra. So Rabbi Law said, in the name of Rabbi Yehuda ben Safra, Amar Kra, because the Pasuk says, V'chagosa moso chag l'Hashem shivas yomim bashona. It says you're going to celebrate, this is talking about the Yontif of Sukkot, you're going to celebrate the Yontif of Sukkot for 7 days. So the drasha is, Shiva, what are you talking about, 7 days? Shmona have it, there's really 8 days in Sukkot. Ela mikan l'chagigo shein adoches haShabbos. You really see from here that a karmen chagigo is not doches haShabbos. So since one of your 8 days of Sukkot most certainly is Shabbos, the karmen chagigo is not going to be doches haShabbos. It's only going to be 7 days maximum. Ki also Ravin Amar, when Ravin came, he said, Amarti lifnei rabosai, I said in front of my rebbeim, sometimes you'll have a situation where the carbon chagiga can only brought on 6 of the days of Sukkot. For example, let's say the first day of Sukkot falls out on Shabbos, so then the first day is going to be Shabbos and the last day is going to be Shabbos. So 2 days are going to be knocked out. Only 6 days are going to be fit for the carbon chagiga. Now, Ravin's statement over here is intended as a question because Ravin is saying, still, if you're going to say that on Shabbos we don't bring the carbon chagiga, why does the pasuk say 7 days? There are some scenarios, really one scenario, if Shabbos falls out and if the first day of Sukkot falls out on Shabbos, there's going to be this one scenario where you're only going to have 6 days. So why does the pasuk say 7 days? So Amar Abaya said back, Avin Tichla was another name for Ravin. It means Ravin who was bereaved because Ravin lost some of his children. Some of his children died. So he said, Lemo ki amil, so would Ravin say such a thing? Shmona lo mashkachas lo klal. 8 you're never going to have. In the holiday of Sukkot, you're certainly going to have at least one Shabbos. Therefore, there's certainly not going to be 8 days that are fit for bringing a Karban Chagiga. But Shiva Isa Barov Shanim, but most years, as long as the first day of Sukkot doesn't fall out on Shabbos, most years there's going to be 7 days available where you could potentially bring a carbon chagiga, and therefore the pasuk makes perfect sense. V'chagosim oso chag l'Hashem shivas yomim, on most typical years there's going to be 7 days available to bring the carbon chagiga of Sukkot. Amar Ula, Ula says, Amar Rebbe Lazar, in the name of Rebbe Lazar, Shlomim sheshachtan me'erev yontiv. If you have a carbon shlom that you shechted erev yontiv before yontiv, Eino yotzei bohen lo misham simcha velo misham chagiga. You cannot be yotzei the mitzvah of simcha with such a carbon. You cannot be yotzei the mitzvah of chagiga with such a carbon either. Misham simcha dechsiv. Now simcha, why aren't you yotzei simcha if you shechted this carbon before yontiv? Because the pasuk says dechsiv is avachta v'samachta. It says you have to shecht it and be happy. Meaning ba'inon zvicha, you need to do the shechita. We're going to say at the time of actual simcha, and we'll continue with this discussion in the next video on Daf Ayin Aleph. Amid Aleph.